Welcome to episode 2 of Don't Drop The Dumbells TV. And we're going to carry on really with what we did in the first episode. And I think we talked a lot about the emotional context of this place. Obviously, most of it untrue. But as is most people's emotions. So I've been thinking a bit about it quite a lot all week, to be honest. And especially because I tried to walk home using the sat-nav app on my phone the other day, and yeah, that just went completely horribly wrong quite soon, and I haven't actually got home yet. But and this is because I kind of think there's a lot of assumption of autism in society today, and especially when, you know, it is still only like 40% of the population that actually has been diagnosed. What you're gonna see when you read directions is things like head southwest at the junction of blah blah blah. And I think, to be honest, if you're drunk and you're kind of in a highly emotional state, that's really just telling you to stab your own arm in terms of context. So what I'd obviously like to hear is things like kind of just slowly drift to the left when you feel the street is losing its sense of adventure, that kind of language. And it's in that kind of context that I think we're going to talk a lot more about what this place means to everyone emotionally. And it did a case, which if your journeys are just emotional, and I thought about it, and all my journeys are emotional, then you won't ever get lost. Or to put it simply, you can't get lost if it is an emotional journey. You can get very cold, very confused, very hungry, but you can't get lost. Although, as I say, I haven't actually got home yet. So here is episode 2. Enjoy the bands, enjoy the place, enjoy your life. Just leave me the fuck alone. Right, so we've come to the end of episode 2. I suppose you kind of get a vague idea of what's going on, which I suppose is what people broadly classify as DIY. But I don't know, I suppose I've been thinking a lot about what DIY culture means nowadays in an era when people refer to building wardrobes from wood as being DIY. As an example, this whole building has had what I suppose you could call a long history of DIY, which started in the 50s with off-street abortions, carried on for a good 30 years, quite kind of happily. And then when the government introduced in the 80s financial incentives for people to have abortions in very, very plush places, the whole notion of DIY abortions was questioned in here, and it got very proactive. And you'd get a lot of people coming down with 5-year-olds, 6-year-olds. I suppose you've got to see as maybe a bit gung-ho in some ways, but actually no, it's just really, really brutal. It's really, really brutal. And maybe you should think about that next time you pay £3 for a gig. But we'll see you next week. Just to think on.